Netcat gives us a simple model of a program using the network, but it's a lot simpler than the way that a standard web browser and server use the network. Browsers and servers don't just handle a single request or a few requests one after the other. They also work on several requests at the same time. When your browser loads a web page from a server, it usually has to load a lot of different files, the HTML itself, plus images, scripts, CSS, and other data. The more that it can do this in parallel, the faster it can render that page onto your screen. Or, imagine that you're in charge of the server that's sending this video to your browser. You're probably not the only person watching it right now. You might be near the end of the video, while someone else is just starting to watch it, so the data that the server is sending to you isn't in sync with what it's sending to that other person's browser. And there are a lot of different ways that programs can handle multiple connections at once. One of the most basic ones is what early web servers did, and what many programs such as SSHD still do. Whenever a new connection comes in, the server process forks. It asks the operating system to split it in two, like a cell dividing. A different model that many more recent servers use is to create a pool of processes or threads, each of which can handle one connection at a time. Now, this is faster than starting new processes, but it does have the downside that there's a limit to how many requests can be handled at once before things start to slow down. And finally, a third model is to have a single process that quickly switches between handling requests as they become available. There are a few different facilities and operating systems for doing this efficiently, such as the epoll function in Linux. But before your server can handle a request, the client has to know how to get in touch with your server. Up ahead, we'll take a look at DNS, the directory system for internet hosts.